Studio 94 is a dynamic brand that has a host of services that they have to offer. The brain behind it all is the wonderful, the amazing Yusuf Kibbe, whose energy speaks before him even before he enters a room. Stay tuned, as today on our show, we have iBoothMe, Studio 94, and the awesome Yusuf Kibbe.
Yusuf, can you tell us a little about yourself and your background?
Well, my name is Yusuf. I'm Lebanese origin. I have had the chance to study in France. Okay. And then I came in Dubai for like a new business adventure.
Okay.
Like it was in 2007 when I came here in Dubai.
All right.
Yes.
Okay. And was this the first business you set up over here when
no,
you came?
No. I have done like several business where I failed multiple times.
Okay.
I got like big slaps, but those slaps helped me to reach where I am today. So yes. I'm very grateful for what happened to me in the past.
Yeah. Absolutely. That's the right attitude to have.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
So I did read Studio 94 at the entrance. That is your brand.
Yes. Right. I mean, Studio 94, why 94? Because this is the region where I'm living in suburb Paris. It's the region 94. And Studio, because I just wanted to give a random name. Strange name. We're not a photography studio. So I just wanted to give like a strange name, Studio 94. But the Studio 94 is the name of our software development company. And this software development company has developed multiple products. Such the most famous product that we have worldwide is iBoothMe Photo Booth from Studio 94.
Right.
Yes.
That brings us to our next question.
Yes.
What is iBoothMe?
iBoothMe, what we try to do is we try to impress the prospects in order to enter into the heart, provide them a unique experience, collect the data, and analyze and remarket them. So iBoothMe Photo Booth, for each events, we do not propose like a basic software.
Right.
First of all, we understand the marketing and sales challenge.
Right.
And we adapt the software in order to make sense into their campaigns. This is why I don't like to call ourselves as a photo booth, but more as a visual experience.
Okay.
This is what we do. So we have been stuck for a few years. People, they were knowing us just for a photo booth, but now they understand the new dimension that we can help brands and help our clients around.
Okay.
Yes.
Very, very
those challenges that we're facing today.
Right, right. Yes. So has the pandemic affected your business? Because you mentioned events.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. I mean, it's if I can give an example, it's like a car going in a wall. It's a smash for us. And I think all the event industry and many businesses have. But I think the event industry, it was like very violent, what we're facing, right?
Right.
It was like very, very scary at first. Yeah, it was.
Mm. All right. But I believe you have adapted and you managed the situation very well.
Yes. Thank God. Because I failed many times before. I learned one thing in my business. And this is like something like drove me success in life and in business is control your emotions.
Right.
So when you have a situation, you have to control your emotions. You have to use your knowledge and put them all together to create something unique.
Correct.
So we try to keep our cool despite, I mean, the company was going like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I try to be, let's see what we can do
because
still brands are here, still money is there and still people are there.
Right.
They're not vanished.
Right.
So let's do something for them. So this is how I took it.
Very inspiring.
Yes.
So iBoothMe is just a small segment under your vast umbrella of services you offer. So can you tell us a little about what else?
Oh,
what are the other
services? You know, I have the chance and the honor that I have built a big development team that have been with me since years, specialized for brands. So we can do, for example, we can create an internal system for a company, for example. For example, if they want like a special CRM or they want an internal management system, we can do it. We can do mobile applications. We can do, you know, we did a mobile application for the Ministry of Defense and this kind of high-end thing. So anything in software for brands, we do. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, that's the direction everybody's going in now.
Yeah, I mean, I'm very lucky because I'm doing this since 10 years. And when this COVID came, my business of physical photo booth and physical event has stopped. But naturally, my other service of virtual and application has flew, right?
Great.
So I'm in a way, let's say, I will not say lucky because I have been hurt, but it's a magnificent opportunity for us to go faster into the future, because this is where it was going, and it just accelerated. Yeah,
sure.
Where we're going. Yeah.
So, for the sake of our viewers, can you also tell us how the industry can adapt in these times, and how have you been able to take your business and do it virtually?
Yeah. See, the thing that I'm trying to say to the event industry, we have to take internet as a country. Right? And we have to take the online visitors as a population.
Right.
Okay?
Right.
And we have to take the advertising online as billboards on the road. So now brands, due to COVID, they are spending online. So like they're putting a lot of billboards. People, they are driving there, but they're not noticing those because there are a lot. If you watch YouTube, I mean, how many times they will stop by advert? You will skip.
Right.
This is the first thing you will do. You will know where the button will appear without looking back. You will skip, right? And our job is to take that, have the attraction through a unique experience.
Okay.
Yeah. So we want to get their attention in order, again, to enter into the heart and the pocket. So this is our job. And I want to tell the professionals not to worry. You know, I have like, I can give you an example if you want. I will not tell the name of the brand because we signed an NDA.
Right.
But it's a very famous car manufacturer.
Right.
They launch their new car. Mm-hmm. And normally what they do, they invite like influencers.
Okay.
They go into a circuit. They drive the car. There's a presentation. There is food. You know, this kind of things. Mm. Just one example like that. And then, the client of the car manufacturer came to us. Youssef, we are going to lose this business because of this COVID. Please help us there. What can you do? So there's a problem, okay, there. And we found a virtual solution for them. What's the virtual solution for them? They selected three influencers around the world.
Okay.
So we send them a box. And when they open the box, there is a car key and a QR code.
Okay.
Below their building, there is the car. So they will take their smartphone, they will scan it, it will open a welcome. They will welcome personally the influencer. Thank you, blah, blah, blah. And they explain them the new feature of the car. Because this was their what they wanted to do. And when he go in the car, he starts to go in the first step, a video explanation of the adventure will tell him what will happen.
Right.
And what is happening? First of all, there will be a video advertising about, for example, the performance of the car.
Yes.
Then he have to answer a question about the performance, all virtually in his phone.
Right.
And then if he's correct, he will get one star. Then he'll have to take a photo about performance or video.
Right.
Then he has to hashtag it into his in Instagram. Once he hashtag it, we'll have a second star.
Right.
And then so on. Performance, design, and I forgot the last one, the same process. Yeah. And in the end, he has a mosaic of 2,000 square. Okay. He has to invite his influencer, each of them, to take a photo with his unique email to complete the mosaic. Once it's completed, the first one, he will win the car.
Oh, lovely.
So you see? And he got the business with that.
Okay.
And the car manufacturer was so happy that they renew it again. Okay. So this is how we solve this problem. Because the people, they think like virtual events is like virtual streaming or just a virtual photo or a virtual conversation or virtual concert. It's more than that. And there is, if I can compare it, that's what I was saying to my people there. We are sitting on a gold mine. Right. A gold mine in money and gold mine in ideas.
Right.
Yeah, literally.
So, so inspiring and... the energy you have, I've mentioned this to you before, and the enthusiasm with which you do everything is really inspiring. So we follow you on Instagram, and I did see that you have de-stressing sessions, and we have some of your staff playing the guitar.
Thank you. Because, you know, the thing is that I believe in two things. I believe in love and positivity. For me, these two things, if you truly believe in them, nothing can hurt you in life. So this is why I, in terms of positivity, we always like cloth, we always like distress. For example, we have like a punching guy where when you're stressed, we punch him, or we play some football there sometimes. We play music, we love. And, you know, Bob Marley is for me one artist that I mean, he's living inside my heart because he helped me through all the hard steps in my life. And this is why Bob Marley is everywhere. And I will not say I'm here because of Bob Marley, but he gave me a lot of things. He gave me a lot of things. And I'm really thankful for Bob, really. Thank you, Bob. we love so much Bob Marley here inside our company that we have our own Bob Marley. His
really?
Name, his name is RJ,
okay.
And he's an amazing guy. RJ, can you come?
So nice to meet you, RJ.
Hi.
Thank you for coming on to our show. And what are you playing for us today?
No Woman, No Cry by Bob Marley.
By Bob Marley, of course. Thank you so much. I'm sure it's been a sheer delight, even for the audience, to hear you.
Thank you guys for distracting us.
Yusuf, how do you see the future of events?
Well, to be honest with you, I did my, during this COVID, when it happened, I have interviewed over 100 events, company owners and photo booth owners. I mean, people who are in the industry to get their feedback, to understand their fear. And to analyze, I analyze some trends in the market, analyze the technology like the 5G and the new smartphone with the new cameras. And it seemed that the future of events for me, because now all the event has stopped.
Right.
There is virtual events who are booming. You can see they're booming everywhere. But when all those vaccines will come, hopefully very soon, I don't know when exactly, maybe in 2022, in the end of 2021, maybe, I don't know. No, the guy who will tell you he knows exactly when, he's a liar. But the thing is that I believe that the future of events is hybrids. It's a mix between physical events and virtual events. Why? Because still people that would like these human interactions. Like, okay, concerts online is nice. But you know what? If you go live in a concert, you will have the hair of your body like that. It's not the same sensation. But still, virtual people, you know? For example, there is a concert. I think it's Tomorrowland, right?
Right.
Tomorrowland, they did hybrid events, physical and virtual. And you guess what? They sold more in virtual. I don't know, maybe for $10 million sales into virtual. And I don't know how much they did in physical. So it's an amazing news. Why? Because we will have a bigger and wider market.
Right.
And we can reach more people. So for me, the future of events is definitely hybrid. And this is why people, they have to adapt straight away and mm-hmm. start to understand what is virtual, the challenge of virtual. Yeah. And you know, you have different, you have new job positions that have been created, like the like interior design of a 3D environment, for example,
right.
to see the user experience UI, you know, mm-hmm. to see how that will feel. So there is new jobs that are created right. for this new trend. Yeah.
Right.
Thank you.
It has been so delightful to be in
thank
conversation
you. It's my
with
pleasure.
You, Yusuf.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for having me in your office.
It's my pleasure. Come on. It's
and
my
for introducing me to your vibrant team.
Thank you
for your time and thank you for having us.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
I'm sure you enjoyed watching this episode. We certainly enjoyed every bit of it. Thank you so much for tuning in. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and follow us on all our social media channels. Hey, I forgot to mention, we were so enthralled by everything that they do here that they customized a QR code especially for our brand, BCWS. What you get with this QR code is a visual representation of your brand that is interactive, it is fun, and can be used at your events. Not just events that you have in person, but events that you have online as well. All you need to do is scan the QR code and follow the steps given. If you'd like to also avail a discount, send us a message and we will issue you a code wherein you can avail a special discount for all our faithful BCWS customers. Thank you so much for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed watching our episode. Goodbye.